Okay. Go, Ghost. Yes, we are. Yes. How do you expect me to type something in chat like this? Wait. No, we're they can't hear you guys. All right, now they can hear you guys.
Okay. Oh my gosh, dude.
I might have missed the button there.
Okay.
I wonder why.
Right. Unacceptable.
If you're wearing sunglasses,
okay, Raze, go ahead.
It's so warm in
here. Raze. Go ahead.
Oh God! All right. Hold the phone. Okay, I couldn't hear anything, and then I had the stream open in the background. Then I heard everyone like three times. So okay, all right. We got our technical issues taken care of. But hello, what's up, guys?
So
my name is raysfire, and this is Team Next Level. We're bringing you guys episode 3 of the Next Level podcast. We're going to just go down the line, introduce ourselves, and then we're going to jump into today's topic of growing your stream. So to kick things off, if you don't know, you're on my channel right now. My name is raysfire.
That was so smooth. We all have to do that now.
It's the sunglasses.
Why do you got to do that, man? Why do you got to show us up?
Hey,
it's
everyone.
His channel. He has to like kick it up a notch.
Okay, Chrism.
I'm Chris.
Oh.
M. Chrism.
I'm Fuzziness. What's up?
I'm sure you're not Neo. I am not Spimmy99.
Sam.
I'm Red Falcon Games. That's so much brighter.
The number one Alex.
Oh, God.
I'm Vesper.
And, yeah, today.
Oh my god,
dude, that was well done. So today, guys, this is a pretty interesting topic we're talking about. So today we're going to be bringing you guys kind of how us as broadcasters have learned, you know, to grow a channel. We're going to be talking about like ways
down.
To do that and things like that. But also it's interesting for you guys from a viewer's perspective, because you guys kind of get a look into like our minds. You can kind of pick our brains, or I guess listen to us pick each other's brains, talking about these topics of stream growth, and you can kind of get an idea as to just how much goes into growing a stream. You know, it's not as easy as just hitting the going live button and, you know, playing a game. So the first thing that we want to talk about today is we're going to be talking about consistency. And I feel like all of us will probably agree that this is like one of the most important things, so we're not going to spend too long on it, but consistency is very important in streaming. So
I don't think I've ever heard a single streamer say that consistency isn't always at like the top of the priority list.
It's yeah. like it it's is. Definitely number one.
Yeah.
You need
and
like,
number one.
It doesn't just mean like having a schedule, like, yo, I always go live at this time of day. It means like when like it means if you want to I lost all my words. It means like you need to be live consistently.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well,
it doesn't,
well,
yeah,
well,
yeah, left my brain.
Well, you don't have to be live at the exact same minute every day, but you should be live around the same time frame, and you should stream a lot, because if you don't stream a lot, you're not growing.
Yeah.
Like,
you
need
to get a momentum going.
If you keep like streaming at like different like times, like, you know, for example, like one day you start at like maybe 2 p.m. And then like, you know, the next day you start like at like 1 a.m. then don't expect like, you know, the same people are going to be showing up right away.
Yeah.
Because, you know, you're streaming at way different times. If you establish yourself as like, you know, a certain time slot and keep that consistent, you will grow your channel very yeah. well.
There's also
still,
times
am
where...
I still loud?
No,
it sounds fine to me. Okay.
It's like breaking a promise to your viewers, in a sense. Even though you didn't promise anything, it's just if someone gets used to something and it just suddenly disappears, they're not gonna trust
think
you
of
as
like,
much.
Think of like a TV show that is always scheduled to be on at like one time during
yeah,
the day, and then it just
yeah.
like changes to like a different time and nobody knew.
Yeah.
Or it just like goes off air and nobody knew. Like, what's gonna happen?
Well, it appears like it's important even outside of just a time frame thing. Like you can like because I know I've definitely been there. You know, I'm a student right now. I'm going to school full time, and trying to stream on top of that can be kind of difficult. And it's not so much from my experience like always going live at the same time. While that definitely helps, it's more about like just letting your viewers know that you're like there now. Like streaming at the same time every day definitely helps, but. Like if you go weeks without streaming, like people are just gonna forget that you're there. So it's like
people are gonna
it's
find
one of those
out.
Things, right? Like that.
Especially if you haven't been streaming that long.
Yeah, for sure. Like when you're trying to get yourself established, it's like key that you make your viewers know that you're there, right? Because like a lot of the bigger channels that you see on Twitch these days are bigger because they're so consistent. Like I'm not saying a break's not necessary. Breaks are good because. You know, you need to sometimes take some time to yourself and refresh yourself, but
it's always important to put your personal health before the actual streaming.
Yes.
Right. But like if you go live at like 1 a.m. on let's say like Sunday, and then you don't stream for 2 weeks, and then you go live at like 5 p.m. on a Wednesday, like that's going to be
this is going to be bad.
It's so unpredictable, you know? Yeah, it's just not good.
There's a couple different I feel like people whenever they think about consistency, they always think of trying to retain new people that follow their channel. But there's also the possibility of what if I find out, or if I'm just like looking on like speedrun.com, like, oh, this person speedruns this game, so I'll follow them because I want to watch them. And then I follow them and they don't stream for like 3 months. And then I see them on the follower notification and then I just completely like scroll right past them or end up unfollowing them because I feel like it's clogging my following feed compared to people that I actually want to follow. So there's also people who could find you from just a random unknown third party from a friend or whatever, and then you won't retain the followers that way. But there's also people, for example, like from giveaways. I mean, from the Gleam giveaways is another way that a lot of people find them. And someone could be like, oh, this is a really cool stream that I liked it. And then they want to watch it again, but enough time passes where their priority of a different streamer that they enjoy takes precedence over yours, so they won't go to yours, and then you've lost a potential viewer or regular viewer at that point. So,
I mean, it really is just like the more you stream, the more people can find you, right? Mm-hmm.
That's
I mean,
another thing.
Yeah, for sure.
If you're not streaming as much, you know, you're just losing tons of opportunities to have more people there.
People are only going to find your channel when you're live. So if you're live more and at like the same times, there you go. More people are going to find you.
And the longer that you're live is... No, good.
Oh, no, I was going to say, speaking of people being able to find you, we should probably talk about also like a game choice as well. Like, you know...
Oh yeah, that's another huge
going
thing.
going into like, you know, really saturated categories, like for example. Mm-hmm. Like I hate to use these as an example.
Yeah. The top like five games on Twitch, you know.
Well, yeah, you do not
League of Legends, Dota 2, Counter-Strike.
Stay away from those categories if you want to grow.
If you're starting out, what I would like highly recommend channels, check the directory of the game you want to play first. And then see if you even have a chance of getting new people to find you with your channel size. If you have one viewer, yesterday I went to the League of Legends directory and I started scrolling for like 10 minutes straight, and there was still channels with one viewers, and they kept coming, and they don't stop coming.
I feel like there's games that you should play on the stream, and then play like games that you should play off stream. Like for example, if you love League of Legends, that's fine. Play it off stream though. Like if you want to grow, that is. If you really are dedicated to wanting to grow, try to find like categories. Like for example, like sometimes there will be like a big streamer that's playing like let's say, I don't know, like Yoshi's Island or something, whatever. You know, nobody else is playing that in that category. That is like the perfect opportunity for you to be like, oh shoot, I need to play that game. And also, if you genuinely like it, do not play a game if you don't like it, because people really will see that
people
you are not
will
liking
know.
The game.
Something just happened.
What happened to Chris?
No,
Chris, we lost Chris.
Alex just split up. I can fix that. Don't worry.
What happened? He was adding so much to the
just
podcast.
Keep going.
No,
man,
we gotta get him back. We gotta get him back.
Chris is gone.
Wait, is everything messed up now?
No, it's just Chris, because I think
no,
just
only Alex. Only Alex is messed up.
Wait, only Alex.
I'm gone.
Yeah, you're like split in half.
I was split in half.
Because you're the one that's on the bottom row, so you're the only one who was moved. But
the number half, Alex.
The void is here to contribute.
Am I on their side now?
Okay, you guys.
0.5.
You guys now know that Alex is actually both Crescendo and...
The truth comes out.
Have you ever seen him come down now? At the same time?
That's why Alex is so hard to get a hold of, because he's always working on freaking We Like to Play YouTube videos as well as streaming as much as he does. It's insane. I don't know how he does it.
It's okay. It's okay if they know. Only the next level peeps. I got it. Like, you know, in our community.
You got it?
It's
cool if
they know. It's cool if they know. But yeah, like I was saying, like, you know, try to find like games that you like genuinely like. That like bigger streamers are doing, and there's like not that many people in the category. People will be able to click on your name, because think of it, like, you know, logically, if you go and like how Chris was saying, there's like a huge category of like, you know, people. Nobody's gonna scroll all the way down, scroll all the way down just to find
there's
one random stream that has like one viewer. Like it's
certain
not
games like that. I mean, there are certain people who like to watch streams that have lower view count numbers, so they'll skip the first two or three, you know, most populous ones, because they want to go to those smaller community streamers and stuff like that, and that's fine. But there are certain games where that's just not feasible, where people are going to find you that way. League of Legends and Dota, those kinds of games are good examples, because they literally have like hundreds of people who are streaming at a time, and it's not only just the odds of someone wanting to watch a lower viewer number, but also the odds of them just happening to click on yours, because if all they're looking at is a thumbnail, there's not really much that can set you out from that point. You want to try to find games that you enjoy. Everyone always says, like, you know, like, oh, I'm gonna start streaming, what should I do? And, you know, the streamer always says, oh, you know, make sure you're playing a game you enjoy. And it seems like it's such a cheesy or like cop-out answer, but it's true. It's so true.
People are not gonna enjoy your stream if you're not having fun.
Exactly.
People will know. You can try your best to hide it. People will know if you're not having fun, if you're not actually enjoying it, if it's not something that you like doing. People will pick up on that, and people will leave.
I feel like we talked about how consistency is number one, and it is, but like, I think consistently having fun is number one. Mm-hmm. Like, we have to, like, if we're going to make that on there, consistently having fun. Yeah. You know, good answer, like Family Feud.
Speaking of directory again, like Chris was saying, it's sometimes also good to have like niche or something different, and that can pull people in as well.
Well, yeah, make sure you enjoy the game stuff.
Because
you gotta enjoy it as well.
Because let's assume that you're a League streamer, right? And you're trying to establish yourself, and you really only like League and nothing else. Like, it's not necessarily like I would say it's easier to grow your channel if you don't stream a game that is very saturated like League of Legends. But if that's literally the only thing you grow or you want to grow, like to play, then it's important for you to make like a name for yourself, essentially, because if you're just providing gameplay, there's like a million other channels out there that people could watch that is just gameplay. You have to do something to distinguish yourself from the rest. Like you have to find,
you need to give that pull. Yeah, you need to give people a reason to watch your stream over
opposed to other people.
Right. Like,
what is different that your stream offers that this stream that they could watch doesn't offer?
And actually touching on that, I think another thing we wanted to talk about was like stream community, actually. So like, you know, if you focus your stream not so much around the gameplay, but you revolve yourself around the community that you build for yourself on Twitch, I feel like that's actually kind of, in a way, a pull in and of itself, because there's a lot of community-oriented channels where people are able to develop these friendships and make friends that last outside of just the stream chat, you know? So I think that that's another important thing to touch on.
And what's also great is that it used to be, when I first started watching Twitch, the only way that could really happen was Skype was the big thing that everyone had, and you had to add people. And even then, that was kind of a risky thing, or someone that you had to an extent, trust, because, you know, the whole being able to get your IP from Skype and that, and getting your information and all that different kind of stuff. So it was definitely a lot less accessible as it is now compared to now they have Discord, which is everywhere. There's buttons underneath most streamers' channels for Discord groups, and everyone always talks in there. And now we also have on Twitch, they just launched today the friends list. That's going to make it even easier for people to build these communities and build friendships and things like that. So I feel like while it was more difficult, it's definitely become easier. But it's so imperative, if you want to go a stream, you need to have like a strong community, because you clearly had something you wanted to say.
Like, I was gonna say, like, community can also be very, very, very important about growing a stream. But it also depends, like, you know, for example, how good you are. So, like, this is rare occasions, okay? I'm going to say this is rare occasions. This will only not happen, okay? But, for example, you're really, really good at a certain game. Like, let's say you're a speedrunner of a certain game, and you just kick ass at that game. You're just so freaking good. Like, for example, if you're getting, like, world records, like, you know, you're just destroying at this game. Mm-hmm. People are going to find you. People are going to, like, you know, stick around, too, because, like, you're really good at the game, and they want to actually just watch you as well.
Yeah.
But if you, like, have that and also, like, pay attention to community and stuff, yeah, like, you can just skyrocket.
Yeah.
Now, yeah, I'm not going to say names, but there have been a couple of streamers out there that I know that have just, like, skyrocketed because of, like, you know, them being extremely good at a game, but also being so involved with their community, mm-hmm, and talking to them, and it's, like, you know, it's amazing. So yeah. And there's so many factors that you can play into that.
Make sure people find you for whatever reasons you can imagine, but make sure
make sure
they stay because of you.
That's one of the reasons people stick around is, what I mean, because of you, and also because of the community, you know, mm-hmm, like that you help create. People want to come and chat and say hi to everyone, you know, that they saw yesterday in the stream, and it all comes around full circle, really.
Go ahead, Fuzzy.
That's like one of the main things I've been focusing on recently. It's just like the word loyal viewers to me and the community, and just like even just trying to push for like Discord or anything, just talk to them every day, you know, even like sub mails, all those kind of things come back at you, and it's always really good if you keep it up.
Mm-hmm. Going back to the whole wanting to bring people to your channel because you offer something unique. What? I'm sorry. Is that not a valid point?
No.
I'm sorry.
Stop making me laugh on the podcast, okay? I'm trying to listen to Noss's words of wisdom.
Words of wisdom, I know. Okay. When it comes to wanting people to come to your channel, you know, you want to offer that something unique that your channel has and no one other channel has. And one thing that's very easy is people. They always say everyone's different, no two people are alike. If you have that community, if you have those people, it's not just people will come to the channel just to watch your streams and to watch whatever you speedrun, or just because you're playing a game that they enjoy, or not just because they like your commentary or think you're funny, but also the other people in the chat, if they're active chatters, or even if they're not active chatters, they could still be lurkers and then still find the chat entertaining as well. If you have a strong community and they're always coming back to your streams, they'll come back just for the community in your channel, as well as what, you know, game you're doing as well.
Right. I'd like to kind of emphasize something that Chris said earlier. He said, like, people are going to find your stream because of the game. They're gonna look through the directory, or maybe they'll go for like a host or something like that. They're gonna watch your stream because of the game. They're gonna see what game you're playing. They'll be like, yo, I want to watch that game. It's up to you to make them stay for not only the game, but for you and the community.
Yes, see, the community, and that goes like with the idea that the community that develops on your channel is like a direct result of the attitude of the personality that you bring to your stream. And actually, yep, I've got an interesting statistic here. I ran this poll on February 4th of this year on Twitter. It was a question that said, and this deals with subscribing to a streamer, but it still applies to channel growth. It was, what primarily influences your decision to subscribe to a streamer?
Yep.
And it got 1,656 votes, and 75% of those votes were streamer personality, and then 12 of them were channel community. So that's like almost 90% on those two things.
Was emotes a choice in that poll?
Yes, emotes was a choice. That was 7%, and player skill was 6% for all the results, just so you know.
That's interesting.
Yes.
Feel like we should... We just said that people should make them stay, but we never said how we should make them stay, because I think those are like really helpful tips people could use.
Yeah.
Oh, so everyone says how we try to make people stay that are new to our channel. And I want to start, whenever I see someone that's new to my channel, I when they specifically say, hey, I'm new, then I ask if they don't already tell me, how did you find my channel? Because that's really interesting to me. And that makes them engage to the chat and to the community already. People are going to talk, hey, I found him like this. And then you get a whole conversation going. Whenever I see a new name, I'll make sure to say hi to them, give them the attention they probably wanted, and make sure they get involved into the whole interaction rather than just watching a stream without
doing
anything.
And then never talk to them again.
Yes.
Yeah. I think
Why don't we just go down?
You want to do that?
I mean, it's just, yeah.
Yeah, sure, that's fine.
For me, it's like similar to Chris. So when I see a new viewer in chat, even if they just say hi or just talk generally, I just like always pay attention to new people because my stream's not overflown yet, so I can manage it just about. So I just like, for my personal technique, I try and ask them questions about them and like not just about me. So like I'm like, oh, what do you do? Because I always find it interesting what people do. And like they've become like friends through that, you know? And I feel like that's one of my techniques to get people to come back.
Yeah, actually going along with that is like touching on the idea that you want to kind of build this relationship with the people in your community. Like people will tell me things, you know, they'll tell me like where they're from or, you know, what classes they're doing, whatever. And I'm not saying you have to memorize every like minute detail about the people watching your stream. But if you can remember like some things like, oh, you know, how was the exam? If someone like told you they had an exam yesterday or like, you know, like how's the weather up in, you know, wherever you're at, you know, stuff like that, showing that you're taking an investment in the people that are watching you is showing that the relationship between the streamer and the stream viewers is a two-way street. So they get to know you, you get to know them.
It actually kind of ties into what we talked about in our last podcast, how the cool thing about Twitch is that you can have relationships with the people that watch you. They're not just viewers, they're friends.
Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm.
And I think one of the things I was going to say
was, do I have a relationship
like,
with you guys?
Yes.
Okay. Yes.
Some all over the place. In a good way.
Always. One of the things I was going to say is for like new viewers, as far as what we were talking about, I always ask them if they have any questions about like the stream or the game, because a lot of the times when you're new to a stream, and especially like for me, when I'm speedrunning a game, you know, a lot of the times they're probably just like, what the heck is he doing? Like, why is he doing that? Why is this happening? And maybe they might be like maybe a little bit intimidated to ask because they're new or something. But if you just ask them, hey, like, what are you curious about? I can tell you about anything about the stream, about me, about the game, whatever. And that just kind of opens the door to conversation.
Especially like, for example, if you do happen to get raided, it's good to like, you know, kind of like, especially if you're a community-based streamer, you know, introduce yourself, but also say like, you know, like I usually say like, like, you know, if you guys have any questions, feel free to ask. I'm a community-based streamer, you know, don't be shy to, like, talk. You can lurk if you want, but, like, you know, if you have questions to ask me, I have information in the profile, yada, yada, et cetera. I love you. Thank you so much for coming in here kind of thing.
Yeah, exactly. You have to be appreciative when you get a raid. And like Chris said, introduce yourself. Tell people what you do, what you usually, you know, you kind of got to give them a pitch. Like there's an influx of people coming in here and you have to like say, hey, this is what I do. This is why you should probably try to stick around.
Because you have, I know it sounds bad, but you literally have 15 like memorized in your head or like a gist. I like to improvise it all the time, depending on who raids me and like what they do and with what message. I try to make it funny as best as I can. Sometimes I fail. Sometimes I do a good job. But you know, it just depends.
It's the same as a party. If you go to talk to someone for the first time, what's your pickup line? You can have something.
Yeah.
long hair.
What are you talking about? But like, you know, it's good to have like, I know it sounds cheesy, but it's good to have like kind of like a pitch, like, you know, that you have like kind of like memorized in your head or like a gist. I like to improvise it all the time, depending on who raids me and like what they do and with what message. I try to make it funny as best as I can. Sometimes I fail. Sometimes I do a good job. But you know, it just depends.
It's the same as a party. If you go to talk to someone for the first time, what's your pickup line? You can have something.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, bar, right? That's it. Anyway. Yeah.
But wait, are we okay?
Is there anything else you guys want to talk about for community, or do we want to like Maybe move on from that.
I just feel like it's important, and now with Discord and things like that, and now with the friends.
Community is like, there's so many things.
It's very easily accessible to do now. It's much easier to do than it was.
Well,
a year.
We should touch base on a community and like, you know, how to like run like, you know, channels and chats and stuff on like a later podcast. But I think we should move on to the next thing. The next level of this podcast.
Oh my god!
Which is, of course, stream quality.
I hope my mic was stream quality.
No, it's fine.
Oh, my ears are
green. Okay. Yeah, I don't know why people are saying my mic is like messed up.
I don't know. I'm
like, how many?
Take it away, Fuzzy. Take it
how
away.
How many of you people have watched the stream with like 4 seconds of input audio delay on the game?
Oh god.
And struggled to watch it.
How about when they like put stuff like all nice and then there's like it's like cut off here and there and then over here it's like overlaying on top of another thing and it's just like little things that just eat away.
There's like certain things that
the stream. You
know. But before wait hold on, I have to say something really important before we get into quality. I'm sorry, this is really important, guys. If you're starting out with streaming, please do not invest so much money into streaming just yet, because you are starting new and you might realize that you might not like streaming. You need to try it out first. Use what you have. I do suggest getting a mic though. Don't buy an expensive one.
Just don't get band mics.
Just get like band mics. Like just get any headset.
If you have Rock Band. Webcam.
There's a C920, the C920 webcam that's really cheap and really popular with like I think like all of us pretty much use that webcam.
Yeah.
Those are just cheap things, like a mic and a cam. Bam, you're good to go. You can stream. Just try to use what you have and go with that. See if you like it. If you like it, maybe you get like donations here and there from people. Use like slowly upgrade, you know?
Make sure you spend time on setting up your audio. The audio is much more important than your video quality. If you have bad internet or your computer can't handle a certain game, then that's fine. People will still watch if they like you. They're not influenced that much by video.
$700 condenser mic with 40 followers. I do see some people like that just like have better equipment than like, you know, like professional streamers and like I mean that's great. They might have a passion, but like geez, you gotta be careful on spending so much money on all that stuff.
Let me finish this. Whenever I see a stream, or even if I really like the person, if they have a microphone and their quality is really bad, like voice activation pops off every couple seconds even though they are not saying anything, or the quality is just horrible, I can't watch it. Even if you're the nicest person on the planet, I'm not going to watch your stream if your audio is bad.
Yeah,
so make sure you listen to your own stream and make sure to improve it as much as you can.
Key.
It a quick thing is that
audio
like,
is such a pain in the ass.
Yeah, audio like, is so important. Like audio is way more important than people realize. Like if you're listening to a stream, you know, some people might have it tabbed out, some people might be tabbed in, but like you're always going to be listening to the audio, and the audio is so important because
it really is.
The more quality you put into your audio, the better it's going to sound. That obviously
it's true. There's so many people out there that use streams for background noise.
Exactly.
They use, like, they just want to listen to, they want something that they want to listen to. And as long as you have good enough audio.
It's fuzzy. Gonna want it on.
So,
well, I mean, in my opinion, I wouldn't suggest
watching if the audio is cutting out and
stream,
if it's fuzzy.
It's not fuzzy, fuzziness. But
not fuzziness.
Like,
if it sounds fuzzy.
My God, please.
That sounds like fuzzy.
He's probably over here.
I got it. I picked it up.
And like, what's he talking about?
I was like, he's totally firing shots at Fuzzy right now.
No. Like, equipment. The best way to compare it is like you're learning guitar for the first time and you buy a really expensive guitar and you're not even there yet to even know if you like it. It's the same thing.
Yeah, exactly. That's
yeah,
really
yeah, yeah. See,
yeah, you're not at
the
experience level to be able to handle that stuff. I know it sounds like
this
bad,
stuff
like,
gets
you know,
really complicated really quickly.
Because I mean, I think about it like as a hobby, because like that's what it is. Like when you start streaming, if you're streaming for the first time, you're streaming it because it's something you're interested in. You want to see if you like it or not. And you don't want to put a lot of money into it initially, because like Fuzzy said, you know, if you're just learning to play the guitar, you're not going to go out and buy a Les Paul. You're not going to drop $1,000 on a guitar before you even play the guitar to see if you like it. You do want to like optimize your settings, because
like everyone's mentioned, if you don't have like, you know, good audio or whatever, like if you don't even try to put in the effort to make your stream like sound or look decent, then people aren't going to watch. But you don't have to buy like, you know, top of the line stuff on day one.
Yeah, it just needs to be good enough, you know? As long as it's not bad, you're good to go.
Yeah, I mean, most of us here probably started with like a Dazzle, for example.
Yeah,
yeah, I started with a Dazzle.
So there you go, point proven.
Yep. Dazzle works fine. You don't need all that flashy stuff from the beginning.
Mm-hmm. And then and green like... screen.
Unnecessary.
Should we talk about green screens? Like, it's unnecessary, actually. It's really unnecessary.
Screen, I'm so torn on green screens, to be honest.
Big screens have
a lot of people, like, you know, are always broken between, like, you know, trying to get, like, you know, green screen set up or not. Mm-hmm. It's just your preference, to be honest. You can still have a very professional stream, like, you know, and everything. Stream overlay and alerts, like, you know, we're going to talk about that soon, by the way. You can still have a professional looking overlay without having a green screen effect. Like, it's not needed. It's just what your preference is.
Yeah,
because having a green screen set up, like, I have to get this, like, nice, like, you know, green screen, and now I have to, like, all have all lighting. These lights and stuff. Like, and you have to get
I tried a green screen for, like, 5 months when my channel was, like, getting big. I hated it. I just couldn't do it.
See,
like,
I
took off the green screen, didn't have the lights shining in my face. It was way better. I felt way more comfortable on stream. So, like, green screens are not make or break for a high quality.
Yeah, I mean, me personally, I like green screens.
If you're
like,
comfortable with it, yeah.
I
mean, I like it,
Go ahead. Okay. When I watch a stream, I actually started kind of liking streams without green screens more. It wouldn't be a deciding factor if I want to watch that channel, but I like not having a green screen in a stream because it makes it look like more casual. Seeing people's like rooms in the back, they are gamers,
adds
everyone else.
It's like personality.
Yeah,
that's the thing, is the personality. Green screens, both and without green screens, have their pros and cons. I mean, if you have a green screen, it can be nice because a lot of people just want to focus on the gameplay. So if you're doing like a 4x3 game, is that the size? I think that's the larger one.
Yeah,
you're talking about 16x9.
Oh, 16x9. That's what I meant. The 16x9 games. It's really
that's why.
Green
yeah, that's why green
it fills up the screen
are
and
good.
It makes it look better. And yep. I feel like with 4x3s, it's better to use without a green screen because a lot of people seem to like the personality and the familiarity of going to a stream and being like you're there because you can be in the same room that you're usually with. You know what
yeah.
I mean?
Yeah.
So they like, have their ups and downs.
I love it when people come into my stream. Like, I love having stuff in the background because then people come into my stream and say, like, yo, Vesper, can I see your sword? And I'm like, oh, yeah, definitely. Like, absolutely.
which one?
Wrong website.
Oh.
Depends what website they're watching on, Alex.
Mm-hmm. Ho ho!
I think, like,
one shoots the beams.
No, you gotta look me up with that one.
Okay.
By the way, Sam, I like that you're doing that, by the way.
What?
In Discord.
What am I doing?
Oh yeah, like.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I was gonna say one thing about green screens is like if you're gonna do it, make sure you do it right because like there's nothing that bothers me more than when someone has a green screen and
little
like
fuzz
just, like,
in the corner.
Like,
see that fuzz in the corner?
Like, okay, like don't do
like,
that.
Like I go crazy
you can't
actually.
Have the right
everyone
lighting.
Wants to see my sword.
Do it.
Oh my god.
That was perfect.
Slowly standing up.
There you go.
Dang.
It's a real metal sword.
Oh yeah. God.
Actually something I've got two things. I've got a story actually and I probably
I love story time with Ray.
But I had a green screen for a while. But I didn't have lighting set up for it, and it didn't work right because, like, I literally was just like a green sheet, like thumbtacked to my ceiling. And one time, like, okay, there were multiple times midstream where it fell down, like while I was streaming. And then there were other times where like I didn't have it chroma keyed right, and like part of my head was just gone, but I didn't realize it,
yeah.
So I just didn't have a head. For like most of a stream.
Yeah, it
takes let me add on this really quick. Let me just say like one thing really quick. If you do use a green screen and you have windows and you stream during times of the day where the light outside goes from bright to dark and dark to bright and stuff that, make sure you check your green screen because the white balance is gonna be it's gonna need to be adjusted so that your green screen chromas properly. Like please look at that. Please make sure you're looking at your green screen while you're streaming to make sure it still looks good.
Please.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, but the other thing I wanted to say actually is that some people are just like not comfortable or, like with the webcam thing at all, and some like don't, you know, have a webcam and they don't have the money to get it.
I want
to
talk about the book.
I just want to say that like while a lot of people will recommend using a webcam because, you know, it makes the viewer feel more connected to the stream or whatever, it's not like a mandatory thing. If we're talking about things that I think it's important to have to grow your channel, I would highly prioritize having a microphone.
Oh, that's
over necessary. having a webcam. If you
want to be partnered, it's basically necessary to have
a microphone.
It's not possible. I don't think
you can't grow without a microphone. I'm sorry to say it,
guys. Webcam is optimal, but you need,
unless you're,
I mean,
like,
Chris, didn't you like not use a webcam?
Insanely good at a video game and people watch just because you're that like jaw-droppingly good, you're gonna want to have some interaction to grow. It's not gonna happen otherwise.
And then also, do realize this, guys, if you are gonna try to grow with only a microphone and not a webcam, it's gonna definitely be harder. It's gonna be a little bit harder.
It's gonna be so much harder.
Because they can't see your like reactions, they can't like feel like they're on like a personal level. But I have seen some people that don't use webcams, that they only use mic, and these are like, you know, smaller streamers, and they've grown quite well because of how witty they are, how funny they are. Like, you have to be very, very good with talking if you're going to do that. You have to be really, really on point with that stuff. Because you'll see a lot of those like bigger streamers that have never used webcams. Like, there's a lot out there, actually, that are really big because of how good their commentary is and like how witty they are and how funny and like, you know, good with words, and like they just like stun you every time, and they also have sexy voices too. If you have a sexy voice, that can help.
A lot of people love them have sexy
velvet
voices.
My first year of streaming, I didn't use a webcam, and I actually started using a webcam only like a month before I got partnered, or after before I got partnered.
Yeah, so
That's all I did.
It's possible to have growth without a webcam, but webcam...
It's definitely possible, but I just want to make sure that people know it's definitely better to have a webcam. Like, we're saying it's possible, but, like, it's not like, oh, you could do either way. Like, I mean, you could, but you will get more viewers if you have a webcam. It's more interactive. That's just the way it is. These are kind of just facts. Microphone is... Microphones, yeah.
I think... well, actually, speaking about, like...
I know,
Not needing or like, you know, not having not having to have something, but like, you know, leaving it up to like the streamer's discretion, you know, to make the decision on what they are most comfortable with. That kind of brings us into the next topic, which is alerts and overlays, which is a pretty controversial topic depending on who you talk to. But
somebody,
you know, hopefully we can at least
with
like
a lot of
provide
stuff.
Some insight.
Like, for example, I'm sure there's like a lot of people here like that. Like, I can probably disagree with what they might do on their overlays or alerts, and they might disagree with what I do. I've had other streamers actually say to me, like, hey, I think you shouldn't do that. You know, I'm not the one that usually says that type of thing to people. But you know, not every overlay is going to work. But just try to go for an overlay that is more comfortable for you, like, you know, but at the same time, don't make it like noisy. When I say noisy, like, you know, have so many different, like, you know, things like on the screen at the same
time.
Keep it simple. Me personally, I like more simple layouts. Nothing like too much. Like, even I get like a little bit irritated with my own overlays sometimes. Like, if I'm doing like a challenge, let's say, I have to have extra text so people know what the heck I'm doing and stuff. But even so, like, I actually don't like that sometimes. Mm-hmm. But like, I don't know. If you can get like a nice, clean, simple, overlay, that's usually the best.
Yeah.
I don't know.
And this is a personal preference for me. But do you guys agree? I don't like it when yellow is like a primary color for a layout, because I feel like that's way too like in your face.
Have you seen a lot of like bright
I've
yellow
layouts?
I've
seen one person who's ever done a good job with yellow layout.
Complimentary.
Are you saying that because Crescendo's not here?
Yo, that's messed up, man.
Wait, does he have a yellow layout?
Crescendo has like not 100.
That's what I'm saying. He has so many layouts. It's hard to keep. He has a new layout for every single game. I don't know. It's also great to focus on not just because, I mean, Alex, what you do a lot of 16 by 9 games and you have a green screen, so you don't have as much of a layout in the sense that when I think of a layout, you have, you know, your, you know, the donor, the most recent sub, and like, you know, your webcam, and yeah, that's pretty much it. If you're doing a challenge run, you have text, but that's pretty much it. Whereas I have like, exactly, if you're speedrunning, you have splits, you know, you have your webcam, you have where the game is. For me, I also have chat on my channel, and then a lot of people will either put like a logo, like for their team, in our case, our team, or just their own logo, whatever their icon is for their channel.
Oh, shoot.
Oh, no.
This is gonna be so
I noticed he was frozen. He was like this.
We're getting more intimate.
He was like,
it's so messed up.
He was giving us the come on, bruh, for like ever.
The come on,
oh, no, we're in the wrong boxes now.
All right, we can fix this. Alex, leave and rejoin.
If you leave, rejoin.
Alex,
we're gonna lose all of our people.
By oh my god,
we were just talking about
layouts too and making sure they look nice. And then that happened. Oh no.
Oh my god. Are you back, Fuzzy?
Yeah, exactly, Alex. He's not in the there we go. Fuzzy, you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay. Hello, how are you?
Random technical difficulties.
Oh my god.
Alright, I love the
show. We got it. It was good.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. What were we talking about?
I'm so sorry.
I had one really simple like sentence that I feel like sums up what a lot of people do wrong with layouts. More information on the screen does not equal a better layout.
Exactly.
It does not. So like
goes to what
showing your daily
busy.
Followers and then your monthly followers and your like recent donor and your top donor and your
followers
yearly donor
second.
And your like 30-year top donor followers per second. Like when you put all that on the screen, like it's just a lot of information to take
it's
in.
It's good to like, you know, be very thankful of like, you know, the things that people do for you. But at the same time, you also have to conserve the space that you use on your stream. Mm-hmm. Like there's some streamers out there that actually there's this one specific one. This person like actually used to have like a crazy overlay. Then this person went to a simpler overlay. But then this person just straight up just got rid of everything. And this is a big streamer, by the way. This person like eventually. I remember this person saying like,
"It's raysfire."
I don't like having any overlay anymore. I think it's just like more professional to like, you know, just have nothing on the screen, but you know, at least have alerts for everything, like show alerts. But like when you're just keeping it just simple, just camera game, that's it. Like, you know, there's also that, like you can
make sure the game
that's
is
fine
big
too.
Too
like what.
Make sure the game is big, almost as big as it can.
Oh, man, I thought you said something else. Oh, my gosh.
No, game should take up majority of the stream. That's
okay, okay.
Twitch, you guys gotta remember, at the end of the day, Twitch is a gaming streaming website. The game should be like the main focus. Like,
that's,
the
game that's should be the main focus.
Let's talk about the alerts, then, rather than the overlays.
Oh, the alerts, okay.
It depends on the stream.
It depends on the person.
Do what
too.
You're comfortable with. Do what you want your stream to appear like. Like
there's
that's always,
so many people.
Never let someone else tell you how your stream should look. That's the first and most important thing here.
I wanna mention follow alerts. I think follow alerts are good for smaller streamers because it always reminds new people to actually follow because maybe someone actually likes your stream but forgot to hit that follow button and he will never find you again. But make sure if your follow alert is super annoying, just think about how all the people that already follow your channel are gonna hear that every single time, over and over again. Even though it might be funny for one that hears it for the first time.
Yeah, but especially if you get a huge raid and you have like freaking like 20 followers back to back to back to back, you gotta think like, would this notification make me want to just rip my hair out if I heard this 20 times back to back to back nonstop?
Yeah, make sure it's not over the top.
I mean, you are here.
I have like a little chime. It goes like, boom, boom. Like, that's it.
I have a follow alert without a sound. It's just like a little pop-up.
Me too.
Yeah, a lot of people do that. I've noticed.
But that's for like, see, guys, like, you got to also think, like, you know, we're a little bit bigger. So like, you know, it happens more often. So, but like, for example, if it's a small stream that's trying to grow, it's an exciting thing when they get like, you know, someone gets
a follow.
I remember like when I was really small.
I remember
like someone follows like, thank
thank you so much for following.
Yeah, I was like, I was like really, it was like Pavlov. It was like Pavlov. We'd hear the notifications, just immediately.
Yeah,
super
like
happy.
I was like so excited every time someone followed. You know, yeah, same, so same.
It was exciting every single.
Just
follow-up.
Just make it depending on like you know your growth with the stream.
Yeah, it's like a judgment everyone, call, yeah. You know. Yeah, it's like totally you have to find what your like limit is. Like mm-hmm. I feel like you know if let's just assume that you know you average like 30,000 viewers a day, like regardless of what game you're streaming. Obviously, you're going to be at the top of the directory, so you're going to be driving in a lot of traffic. You're going to be getting a lot of new followers. And you're probably not going to want to have that follow alert because it's probably just going to be going off constantly, you know, like especially if it has like a sound, right? But no one's going to like tell you to stop using it or to keep using it. Like that's on you to make that determination. And there's no right or wrong answer. There's like, you know, people can give you tips and advice all day and there might be some backing to that. But if you disagree with like what they say, it's your stream. So, I mean, you can choose to follow it or not. So, you just need to find what works for you.
I was just going to say as well. Good. Sorry. Like, you're going to get haters regardless. Like, some people just don't like certain things. So, it could be, like, the volume of your alerts. It could be how it looks, like, what it is in general. And, like, at the end of the day, it's your stream. And not everyone's going to like everything. And that's just something you got to accept. And just find like a middle ground between you and your viewers.
Yeah, you can't please
like,
everyone.
Acceptable.
That is honestly a huge point about streaming in general. Not even like your overlay, your follow alert, like something that you should know is that you're not going to please everyone. There's going to be people when you're growing that say, you know, don't do this. This annoys me. Don't do that. And like, you know, like we say at the end of the day, you got to go with your gut and you got to go with what you think is going to propel yourself to
it's
grow.
It's good to listen and try to understand why people don't like certain things, but it's your decision.
Just because someone's vocal about something doesn't mean everyone thinks that, you know, you can't let them deter
that's,
you.
That's another good point. Yeah. That you bring up is because always try to do you. Try to be unique. Try to just be you yourself. Always like, you know, don't try to like they were saying, like, you know, get affected by what other people say. Because, like, you know, not everyone, like, is going to think that way. And then also, it's your stream, you know? Mm-hmm. You can't.
Yeah, it's not their stream. Tell them to go start up a stream.
There's going
to
be so many people out there that are, like, tell you what to do. Like, oh, I don't like that follow alert. It's dumb. Well, it's too bad. It's what I like. So if you don't like it, then get out of here. Like, it doesn't matter. This is what you have to do. And if they're going to be rude about it, you just ban them. Whatever. You're done. Yeah. Move on.
See you later.
And that's such like, a minor thing too. It's so minor.
It's like one out of like 100. Complaining.
Donation alerts. Okay. Deletion alerts, I have to say. Now they're alerts in general, I don't think they should be like 80% of the screen. I've actually seen some alerts that are like 80% of the screen.
I think
screen.
We can all agree on that.
And that's really bad. Like if anything, max like
10%,
50%. I was gonna say 50 max.
It should be noticeable. That's...
See, and again, this is just an example of like the personal preference thing, right? There's no
that
right or wrong.
Shouldn't get up there. There's no right or wrong. Like I said, yeah.
No, I think it's pretty wrong to have 80% of your screen.
I think we can all agree. just whatever you do, don't have like some huge image or something like all over the game feed.
But if you do have it, make sure it's a GIF of you. Laughing or something, I don't know.
Yeah,
that's super beautiful.
Well, I've actually seen some
or dancing around. I don't know.
You want to get people use, like, see that GIF so they donate. That's exactly.
I think one of the funniest things I've seen is like people get GIF, GIF, whatever. They get like a GIF of their face and they put it over their face cam. So like when someone donates, it's just like their face on top of their face. I think that's funny. I don't know. That's just something
that
I saw.
That's cool. I've never seen that before.
Funny, actually.
I think like I ate your pie is that maybe some other people do, but it's funny.
Okay.
Anyways, moving on. Oh, God. All right, we're gonna be talking about. We've got two more things left
really
that we want to talk about.
You started it, not me.
Social media.
Social media is huge because with the community.
Does tie in with the community because I mean you can't.
I thought Ray's was gonna say something. Shush.
Okay, sorry.
No, let him go.
Tell him how you feel. Tell him how you actually feel.
I just need a dunce cap at this point.
No,
I might have that.
Sam, I don't think it will. It'll be fine.
Forget that one, sorry.
I was just going to say, I mean, we have like the Discord, but I feel like the difference between Discord and things like Twitter and Instagram.
Well, okay, we didn't talk about like Twitter and Instagram and those. That's more like social media. I wouldn't say Discord is... Oh, okay. Okay, sorry.
I was going to say the difference is with Discord, you're interacting with them one-on-one with the sole purpose of talking to people or like in groups and things like that. Whereas Twitter is more like just giving up-to-date information about what you're doing, daily pictures or text-wise, and you can respond to people. But it's more interesting, I feel like, when you're going to Discord, you're just having a set conversation, whereas Twitter or Instagram is more giving people information and updates about what your day-to-day life is going on.
Or the stream.
Yeah, totally.
Like, or stream, updates. Exactly.
Well, see, me personally, when it comes to Twitter, I'm not a person, like, I know there's other people that, like, you know, do different things with Twitter and stuff. This is just me personally. I don't like talking about anything depressing. I don't complain. Mm-hmm. I don't like bring personal issues. I don't like shoot fires at anyone.
There's nothing.
I think that Twitter should just only be about talking about positive things about maybe something happened in your life that's positive, really nice, or big opportunities. Mm-hmm. Going to conventions, posting pictures,
videos of puppies. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean,
bunnies.
Just try to stick it.
And cute birds.
And cute birds.
Retweet those.
Yeah, like, you know, when you look at Twitter and you look at your newsfeed and before you click on unfollowing someone, why would you unfollow that person? Just don't do what they're doing. Mm-hmm. That's number one rule.
If you don't want to.
I think that could actually be applied to your stream too.
You brought up something really good, Fuzzy, but go on, Raze.
All I just wanted to say is that what he said applies to your stream too. So if you're watching a stream and that stream is doing something that you don't like, then don't do it on your stream. you'd think that would be pretty obvious, but
when it comes to networking though, guys, especially if you're you're trying to I guess get noticed by senpai. I hate that meme.
I hate it too so much.
I need to say it that way. But don't get discouraged if you're trying to get let's say a bigger streamer to follow you back or get them to notice you. For example, you're starting out streaming and you want to be friends with someone. You also just never get discouraged by those kind of things because mm-hmm. It can also just make you feel in generally in a bad attitude anyway.
You're inferior.
I rated that person, but they didn't even acknowledge me. They didn't even follow me. You have to realize other streamers have a bunch of different streamer friends that they deal with and interact with. And it can get busy as hell. How many people that you have to talk with. So you have to also understand it's hard as well. So don't get discouraged about stuff like that. I really don't want people to, because I see people that get upset about that stuff and they complain about it.
On this topic, when you're really small and you're trying to grow, rating people, rating streamers, not huge streamers, but rating medium-sized streamers is a good way to get them to know that you're a streamer, right? Even if it's just one person, mm-hmm. even if it's just two people, even if it's just you, just say yo, I'm rating you. Then they'll be mm-hmm. yeah. Oh, this person streams. That's pretty cool. I should check.
We're never
going
to be have two people in your raid. Get out of here.
When it comes to rating, I feel like rating is the most polite way to get your name out there and your stream out there because
don't pressure it on them as well.
Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah, you're not pressuring.
Never pressure it.
Never pressure it, but the thing is, if I, if someone comes to my channel and they host me or raid me with, five or six people, it's nice to know that, one, now I know, I might not have been on that person's stream before, but now I know that they stream, which is new information to me, but it also, it's nice, and I'm happy that someone liked my stream enough that they want to introduce new people to my stream,
right.
So it's like...
Totally.
It's the perfect way to not only help another channel, but potentially help yours as well, scratch each other's backs kind of thing.
Yeah, I just want to say the other way around. So it's very bad to go to someone's stream and go, oh, can you please host a raid me after you're done?
Oh, God, that's yeah, don't ever, do that. Don't do that. Don't ask.
To be honest, I really think that, like, you know, the general audience in here is pretty aware that they shouldn't do that. I would hope.
Yeah, most people.
I think it's worth mentioning that you should not ask it is worth to be supported.
Never ask.
If they really want to support you, they'll do it themselves.
Yo, we should do Twitch etiquette sometime on another podcast.
Twitch etiquette would be a good one.
Yeah.
I want to say one more thing as well.
Because we shouldn't get into it now because it would take forever.
Speaking of networking, going to events is on.
Going to events, yeah.
Right. Meeting people in person is the best way to build like a strong connection with them. Like, because you can't beat it.
Once you actually meet the people, like, you're like, wow, this person is really nice. Like, yeah, I want to support this person. Mm-hmm. Once you actually meet people, for example, like I'm a little bit picky. Like, you know, I really want to meet people in person. Like, mm-hmm. you know, before I actually start like really getting to know them well. It's sometimes it's difficult, you know, as well. Wait, what? Why are you smiling?
I'm sorry. I'm just thinking like, of my own story that I had.
Oh, you're on story. Well, once I met Nas. Mm-hmm. I couldn't stop thinking about him.
I know.
Every night I have Skype calls with him in bed and just talk to him all night until we fall asleep.
That's how strong the connection is, that we're actually using Skype.
I feel like
they have to see each other.
Yep.
Okay, I can say personally, like for me personally, I would absolutely not be where I am right now if I did not meet people in person decided to support me.
Same.
Like, no way.
That's perfect example. If I never met Vesper in person, I would have probably never asked him to join the team.
Yeah.
Because now I found
the same way with us.
Yeah, same with Sam or like most of you guys. Because I met you guys in person, I found how awesome people you are, and then I checked your streams out after. So I found you guys. And I liked your content, so I asked you, "Hey, you want to do something?"
I don't think I would have been a part of the team either.
Want to be on Baby Smiles?
Met Chrism actually.
I invited Alex. Well, yeah, I've met Alex. That's true. Yeah.
Well, you met me. Yeah, but still, like, if I hadn't met you,
that was really
brief. Like, you know, I wish I could say a funny story, but I don't know if I can.
Actually, true story
about me and Chrism.
Wait, what? Which one?
Let's go right now.
Story time.
Yeah, you gotta bust it out.
Is it okay to say it? Wait, hold on. Keep talking.
All right, Raze,
keep talking.
Keep going.
Raze, you say what you want to say. Alex, just type it to Chris. See if it's okay.
Oh, God.
Yeah, do that. Yeah, actually, the reason that I'm on this team is because I went to SGDQ and Vesper and Crescendo and Chrism. They kidnapped me. They literally picked me up.
Did you really pick me up?
They picked me up and took me to this bar, and I sat at one end of a table, and they all sat on the other end. but I like to say that for effect, right? And then they interrogated me. They're like, all right, we have a business proposal. I have to. We want to present this idea to you. And I was like, oh my god. And I didn't know who Crescendo was. And he's like, yeah, I've got like 480,000 YouTube subs. And I'm like, Jesus Christ, dude.
I remember when we had that Skype group before Discord. And I think I was the only one that didn't go to that SGDQ. I remember specifically planning like, all right, we got to get like raysfire for dinner. Like,
it was really funny.
Go.
Yep.
We all sat down. Before we said anything, Raze was like, okay, what is this about, guys?
We all sat down at the table, and I didn't know any of them very well, so I looked at them, and I'm just like, what is this? You're not just gonna... people I don't know aren't just gonna take me to a restaurant.
Unless they wanted to do something to you.
That's true.
People you don't know kidnap you to take you to a restaurant. Interesting.
All right, Alex, you want to bust out the story?
Oh, I mean, I hyped it up too much. Like, it's bad. Like, actually, it's funny because it'll be short. Like, yeah, like, actually, Chrism didn't like me at first. He didn't like me at all.
I had a really bad first. I had a really bad first impression.
The really great thing that I love about Chrism is actually he's just straightforward and blunt, and he doesn't like beat around the bush or anything. He just doesn't mess around. Like, if he says something, he really means it. He's not bullshitting. He's just telling you like the truth. No, usually.
Totally. Yeah,
he was very straightforward. He didn't like me at first, but then like, you know, once I had met him, and then also like he's checked out my streams more and like actually like got to see my actual personality, because you know maybe people can get the wrong impression mm-hmm. of me because of how I might look like and match with my personality, because this look doesn't match with my personality in all honesty. Then afterwards he was like, you know what, actually Alex, I used to, he told me like one day, Alex, I used to not like you at all. Like,
supposed to be your Chris impression?
I don't like your stream.
I love his Chris impression.
Hey, nice to meet but you know what? I didn't like you, really.
I really like you, Alex. I really like you.
Well, that accent, what the hell is that even?
It's spot on.
And like, you know.
It's not spot on at all.
He is.
Don't even lie to him.
And see, that's the thing. No, I'm just trying to make a point. My point is that sometimes you actually have to meet the people to really see what they're like, because, you know, we're all behind a camera.
Yep.
We're all behind a camera. And like, you know, people are probably going to think like, Alex is not like that in real life. Mm. But, you know, actually, I am no different on my stream than in person. I'm like the same exact person. And all these guys that you see right here, they're exactly the same in person as well, because these guys are freaking fantastic. I love you guys. Aww. But no, but seriously, like, you know, it just goes down to just meeting people in person really helps with mm-hmm. them getting to know you. And
there's also, oh, sorry, I totally cut you off there.
No, it's okay. I mean, I was wrapping it up, but it's just really important. There's two sides. There's networking on Twitch online. There's networking at conventions and stuff, and really meeting people, because you know, that will really help with growth as well.
There's also the fact that sometimes you could get a first impression by someone that just happens to catch them on an off day, or just, you know, sometimes people just have foul moods or whatever. They might have just been playing a game that you didn't enjoy. There's tons of different reasons why you can get a bad impression of someone.
You gotta be careful.
And when you meet them in person, you don't, you might have a first impression, but it's a lot different, especially if it's at a thing like a convention. They're usually in a much more positive atmosphere and they're having fun, hanging around with friends, and they're much more enjoyable people. There was one person whom I met a while ago, and he was just like this very, very cocky person. I was doing a speed run of Splatoon and he came into the chat, and it was the first time I'd done a run in like 5 or 6 months. So I was doing like really old school strats, and he's like, wow, these are some really old strats. I don't think I've seen anyone use these in like months. I was like, gosh. Oh, do you run this game? And he goes, do I run this game? And then he like completely disappeared from chat. And I went to his, I ended up following him and looking at his channel. I was like, oh, this guy has world record. And it ended up being someone who I met at AGDQ, and he was like a really friggin' nice person. He was really funny, like really funny, and I frequently talk with him all the time. And it ended up being Toes Balloons.
He's in chat, yeah.
It's in chat. Oh, he doesn't care. We tell the story.
Like, no, you might catch him at a wrong time, and it sucks because that's gonna be the first impression.
Yeah, you only have one first impression.
There's always stuff like that. So like, I feel like you guys should also. Give other people a chance as well if you're checking out other people. Another chance.
Just like a fantastic person. I love that guy. So, you know, you can have these networking things where you talk to people online. It's completely different when you actually talk to them in person and hang out with them. And
also, like, if you go into someone's stream sometime, like, you know, they might not be, like, at, like, the best mood. Like, you know, maybe something happened and, like, you know, you might catch them at a wrong time. And it sucks because that's going to be the first impression.
Yeah, you only have one first impression.
There's always stuff like that. So, like, I feel like you guys should also give other people a chance as well if you're checking out other people. Another chance. Just like, in case. You never know. You never know.
Because, like, streamers are people, too, you know? Like we're behind the camera. We try to be in a good mood all the time, because obviously you wanna have fun and you want the people watching to be entertained. But like, you know, everyone has their own stories. Everyone has stuff going on behind the scenes. Even people that are streamers off stream, and sometimes people just aren't always going to be in the best mood. And first impressions are important, but sometimes like. You know, it's just a bad time. You know,
whenever I tweet something, whenever I say something that might hear, like, a lot of people might be listening, I always make sure, hey, there might be a lot of new people who see this tweet or listen to me right now, so I want to make a good first impression. Like, after getting a raid or a host always make sure to think about that. There is new people that are going to see you, and you want to make sure they get the right impression.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, guys, we need to go quick. Do we go do Q&A? Quick fire Q&A.
I think we're done with all our...
I think,
to talk about this. Yeah.
Q&A.
You guys have any questions? Any
Race questions gonna pick about... the questions.
Yeah, I'll pick the questions just so we have these contained. But yeah, if you guys have any questions...
While we're waiting for those questions, if you have any questions, Ray's actually just continue what you were saying. Sorry, I cut you off.
No, I was just going to say, if you guys have any questions, drop them in chat. Preferably we'd want something relative to the topic, but it didn't have to be. So
real quick before we're waiting for some questions, grab some questions real quick. I forgot what I was going to say.
Nice.
I can say also feel free to shove questions on the YouTube vid.
I was gonna say when it comes to networking, I wanted to leave off with this. When it comes to networking, please do not be so aggressive with people, because you also have to realize what does this guy want from me kind of thing. What does this person want from me? If you're too aggressive with networking things, try not to be too aggressive with trying to hang
don't
out with
force
someone.
Connections.
Yeah, don't force connections. Them. Yeah,
it's nice
you can
to,
make them feel uncomfortable, and you might burn the bridge forever with that person.
Yeah,
like you
nice
might burn
to,
it forever.
Yeah, don't be shy. Don't let introduce yourself. Don't let an opportunity pass by. But if it's not working, just back off. Don't freaking
force
yourself
into it. If you guys see any good ones, if you guys see any good ones, let's just
actually
paste it in the Discord.
Tones did ask. Nas mentioned yellow was bad. Is it really that bad? It's a personal preference for me. What do you guys think about having vibrant yellow?
I wouldn't pick
bright colors are usually not necessarily
there's no
good.
Reason to
just
use
from
bright
a design
colors, it takes
perspective
away from the game it takes away from the cam, it takes away from everything else.
Also google real quick colors that match with personalities and moods.
Look
and
up
stuff.
A color palette match.
Yeah, that could help with you too, guys.
That's what I did for mine.
Or get someone that's a graphic designer to do a layout for you. If you don't think you could do it on your own, just get someone else.
Someone asked, is this just a regular podcast? We haven't mentioned we do this podcast around once a month, and it's gonna be on a different channel from all teammates every month. And it just happens
recycle
to be
through our teammates.
This time on Racefire's channel, and then next month it's going to be on a different channel.
Yep, and we always shoot for the first Thursday of each month.
Yeah, if we can.
That's pretty much what it's going to be, unless we tell you guys otherwise.
Yeah.
All right, so moving into the actual Q&A, because we do need to kind of do this pretty quickly. So I think the first topic that we wanted to talk was posted by, I'm trying to get the name here, Aleva, I think that's how you say that. Who wants to know advice for female streamers who are trying to get themselves started, and how they should go about growing their channel as well. And my advice would be to just stream, be yourself like you would otherwise be, the negative stigma attached to female streamers, I think is a pretty silly thing. And I think honestly the best way to handle that is to just stream like you would otherwise,
there
and don't worry.
Nothing you should be.
Don't
should
worry about
different.
Don't worry about people who are female. Don't worry about people who are male. Like the gender is not important. Just stream as if you were a streamer.
Just be yourself. Just be yourself and keep doing what you do.
I watched a lot of female streamers recently, and I just say don't feel pressured.
Oh,
to wear
have
makeup.
You been?
Yeah, and don't feel pressured to wear makeup if you don't have to.
One
oh,
thing,
yeah,
that's a big one.
Yeah, that is true.
Well, like, for example, try to be too flashy, because it also can be attract really bad part of Twitch at the same time, which you got to be careful about, because there's a lot of
ahead.
I think that's gonna happen regardless of whether you're
thick skin. You need to understand there are going to be people out
thick
there.
Skin.
Thick skin. I mean, just as a streamer myself, all of us have dealt with people who just assholes and try to break us down and everything like that. With Twitch, and especially if you start getting more popular, there are lots of people out there who are going to try to break down. They generally, from what I've seen, try to target female streamers more, and you need to understand that's going to happen. You need to have thick skin for that. That is very
you need good
important.
Mods too. Good moderators.
Yeah, I was literally just gonna say, please, if anyone's bothering you, please just ban them. Don't even
acknowledge it.
Yeah,
don't
just
acknowledge it. No,
don't give
not.
Them attention.
If they're affecting you or your stream at all, they don't deserve to be there. Just right. get rid of them if they're harassing you or anything like that.
So another question I have here by Cheeseman Fu is, How do you suggest people how do you suggest people to ensure people are hooked about interaction when you have no viewers, aka nobody to actually interact with? So I think that ties in a lot to when you're first getting started. How do you bring in viewers, and how do you keep those viewers there, and how do you start building
how
that
base?
How
do you push through the zero viewer barrier?
Yeah.
And that's
you gotta do. You gotta try. You gotta
commentate on yourself.
What I always did, I asked myself questions that I didn't expect an answer for, but could get an answer for. That's just how I talk when I play video games. I always ask myself questions, and then chat would just out of nowhere, there was a viewer saying, "Oh, you should maybe do this." And then he answered my question, and I didn't expect that. So make sure you always do commentary, even if there's no one to talk
good
to.
Good idea.
Right. Mm-hmm. Make sure that, like, even if there is no one to talk to, make sure you're creating openings for people to get their input in if there is people there to talk to you, you know? Like, you always want to put your potential viewers in a situation where they can talk given the opportunity.
Because you might actually have people coming through your channel, but then they don't know how, because, like, there's nobody in there, nobody's talking, so it's harder for them to, like, you know, like, say something. But if you're constantly, like, you know, commenting on yourself and stuff like that, they'll be like, well...
They might chime in.
They might like say something.
You can always just give a shout out. When you see your view account, if you're starting out, it's probably best if you have it open so you see if there's zero watching or one or two, and you can just give a shout out to your viewers even if they're not in chat. Like, you have two viewers, you're starting out, and you say, "Hey, thanks for watching today. I really appreciate it," and just keep going. And maybe they
react to that.
Yeah, I do. Yeah, everyone does.
I still do that.
No, I think we do.
It's a good thing to do, like, because I mean, you realize, like, you're streaming and people want to come, like, to your channel and watch you, but they're taking time out of their day to watch you, and you want to make sure that you show your appreciation to them. Like,
totally.
By doing that. That being said, do not call them out of the viewer list.
Yeah, no.
I wanted to say it. I wanted to be the one that said that.
When I started streaming, I had a bot would actually say hi to every single person that it saw.
Oh, you were that person?
But when I first started, it was worse when I got raided by a big raid, is because my bot would just be like, and it said, like, hi to, like, every single person that came in. No. So don't do that. Learn from my mistake.
Don't even look at your viewer list. Like,
don't do it. Don't open it.
You shouldn't look at it. Yeah.
The only time you should ever say hi to someone, the only time you should interact with a person is if they say something in your chat. Never call someone out of lurking. Never, ever.
Someone
doesn't matter how big you are,
chat,
how small you are, like, never do it.
Urge them, tell them, you know, don't call out people.
I remember going to streams where a chatbot would say hi immediately after I entered. That just makes me immediately leave the stream
again. Just leave.
Immediately.
Gone.
So one more thing to touch on before we move on to the next question. Someone said...
That was like the first week that I did it. And then I stopped after that.
I had the same experience as Chris very recently. Yeah.
So someone said... I don't always ask questions. I just stay pretty quiet. Well, I think what Chris is saying more is like... maybe this isn't what he's saying, but this is what I'm going to say. It's like... but you ask the questions, like, hypothetically to yourself. Like, whenever you're trying to stream to a low, like, view count audience and you're trying to, like, generate that chat interaction, I think it's important to talk about things that allow for, like, a leeway into some sort of conversation. So if you're playing a game casually, do commentary. Like, talk about what you think about the game, what's going on around you. If you're doing a speed run, talk about the strats you're using. Yeah, think out loud. Don't just think in your head.
Yeah.
You already know in your head.
Yeah, when you're a streamer, you don't think.
The best thing is to be able to interact with your viewers is to think out, like, every single thing that you think in your head, just say it.
Maybe not everything.
Like, for example,
God, my ass is so itchy right now.
My first streaming. Just, like, generate people talking in the chat over time.
Yep.
Just, like, you know, stay on topic. Think of, like, what you, you know, anything that makes you happy to talk about. Just, like, open up. Open your doors.
Okay, so we've got one more question, guys, and unfortunately we didn't get to get to everyone because we are on like
we never will.
Yeah, we're never gonna get to all you guys, but if you hold on to those questions, we do these QAs at the end of like every podcast, so definitely like bring it back in the future and we'll see if we can get to you guys, because like we do if you hold on to those questions, we do these QAs at the end of like every podcast. So definitely like bring it back in the future and we'll see if we can get to you guys, because like we try to keep it based on the topic, but we can talk about whatever. Anyways, the last question we have here is, I lost the name of the person who said in chat, so I'm sorry, but it says, I've been streaming for almost a full year with about 60 followers. I don't have a lot of chatters in my chat, but I'm energetic most of the time. How can I improve my attitude and my voice to be more recognized? Well, that kind of goes back to what we were talking about with the whole, like, you know, finding ways to introduce conversation. But as for like your voice and how, and as for being more recognized, I would say like, you shouldn't worry about those things, because if you're streaming and you're doing the things to grow your channel, you're taking the steps, like those things. Okay, well, first of all, your voice is probably fine. That's all in your head. I know a lot of people don't like their own voice, but second of all, like the recognition and whatever, like that just kind of comes with stream growth, you know, like they're not independent of one another.
Guys, it all comes down to patience. Just be patient. Yep. Like, I know it sucks. I know it's frustrating. You might say, like, I've been doing this for, like, 3 years and I'm only at this amount.
Mm-hmm.
I just can't tell you how just being patient and consistency. You have to keep up with the inconsistency, you know?
It all comes down. And a lot of it can be, like, make or break, being right place, right time.
You might be streaming
one right raid, that going to the event and meeting that one right person, stuff like that. But it could be make or break and can have a huge jump in your channel viewership or follower wise or whatever. Right. But the thing is, you're never going to have those, you know, being at the right place at the right times if you're not streaming, if you're not forcing yourself to go to these events.
The people here that are watching who are new streamers or are who, you know, kind of new streamers or who might stream in the future, you're going to stream for a long time with zero viewers, with one viewer, with two viewers. It's going to happen. Everyone started there at one point. And it's going to suck, but you can power through it. I know you can, and it's going to be awesome once you start getting that viewership.
Exactly. Yep. You gotta,
I just want to say, like, someone motivated me to said, like, you should never go in with expectations and just have fun and enjoy it. And if it
never
grows, you'll love even more if you worked hard and you didn't expect anything, because you're just having fun while doing it.
That's why we say having fun is so important, because no matter how many people are watching, no matter, you know how many followers you have or whatever, if you're having fun, you're having fun. So at the end of the day, like, you know, you're not losing anything.
You shouldn't go in with the mindset, oh, I expect these numbers. You expect it to be fun. That's what you're expecting.
Right.
You know, guys, it's about having fun, and that's what you do. You have fun,
other people will.
Because remember, if you don't have fun, no one's gonna want to watch you.
Damn it! I wanted to cut him off.
No, it's okay. I like it. I was testing. I was testing to see how
I like
much.
Like, bop, bop, bop. No, I'm gonna let you finish. But
okay,
Christmas is the best Mario Maker player ever.
I think we should wrap the questions up. I'm sorry, guys, if we can get your questions. We do need to stick to this, schedule for the podcast. We're going to go into announcements, I think, right?
Well, okay. I wanted to say one more thing. Then we can do announcements, all right? Because I feel like it's important. In the question, he mentioned how long he's been streaming for and the number of followers he had. And I think it's important to realize that if you compare yourself and your rate of growth to other streamers, all that's going to do is make you upset.
Never compare. Any growth is good growth.
And if you're looking and seeing like, oh, well, my stream's growing, but that guy's stream's growing like 20 times faster, you're going to undermine your achievements, even if they are like great in scale, and you don't need to do that. Like,
there's always someone that's going to pass you in growth. And it sucks to see that, but it's just how it is. You just got to deal with that. Mm-hmm.
Anyways, that was the last thing I wanted to say.
Guys, stay true to yourself.
Oh god.
Never.
But
ever compare yourself. I'm gonna keep talking until Ray
like
can't.
Stepped on never all give up. Toes of what we just said with that voice.
But that being said, I think we're gonna be wrapping up questions for now, guys. Again, if your question didn't get answered and you really want to hear like our response, hold on to it, because again, we do this at the end of every podcast. But we're actually going to move into announcements here, and we'll go ahead and just go down the list of all of us, and then we'll do team announcements and wrap things up here. So I guess we'll start with Mr. Chrism, if you have any announcements that you'd like to talk about involving your stream.
Stick around, guys.
Okay, personal events, I have nothing coming up, but the 602 was rescheduled to the 25th of June.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm sure if it was the 4th or 25th.
Me, Nospimi, and Crescendo will take part in that. It's a Mario race, 3D Mario race, where we play Super Mario 64, Super Mario Sunshine, and both Galaxy games, all 100% in one sitting, and it's going to take most people over 24 hours. And it's a big race, a speedrun race, on the 25th of June. That's it.
All right, I'm next. Crescendo, you got any announcements?
All right, cool. Moving on to the next person.
Hey, so,
yeah. So for me, fuzziness. I've been in contact with the Steel Stick N64 person. He's been making basically Steel N64 controllers with a different plastic bowl, so they last a lot longer. And I might have a prototype in the next week or two, so I might be getting back more into N64 stuff, like speedruns again. So
nice.
That'd be awesome. And I can also demonstrate, show it to you guys if you want to see it. That'd be cool.
So Mr. Noss, what do you got?
I actually have two very big announcements.
Yes, he tweeted about this.
First, as of tomorrow, I'm launching my first shirt, which I'm excited about. It's going to be a Nasty Party shirt. Flame did so good with it. It came out so well.
Yo, are we going to talk about the thing between us?
No, I think I don't. Are you trying to steal my thunder? This is all about me right now, and you want to make it about you as well?
Shut up, Alex.
And the other big thing is, starting from May 13th, so not tomorrow, Friday, but the Friday following, I will be the streamer who will be partner spotlight.
Oh my god! We totally didn't know that already!
Oh my god, right?
Oh my god.
Partner spotlight! I know. So I've been preparing a lot of stuff for the channel. I've been finishing learning my DK 64 101%.
But what is the partner spotlight?
Yeah, partner spotlight is, for people that don't know.
Yes, partner spotlight is a program for 1 week from a Friday to the next Friday. One partner streamer, for as long as they're streaming, they will be on front page. They might not be first slot, but they will be on the front page of the chat of Twitch. So that means we're gonna have a lot of new people coming into the channel. It's gonna be really hype. I'm gonna be streaming bare minimum people. 8 hours a day. I'm gonna be trying to push for 12.
Lots of friendly people.
Love people. One of those days, I'll also be doing a 301, which is Banjo-Kazooie 100%, Banjo-Tooie 100%, and Donkey Kong 64 101% back to back to back. It's the equivalent to the 602, but for Rareware games. So that.
What about Diddy Kong Racing?
No.
Oh my god.
Yo.
What about Kong's that 30?
Okay, collectathons. We'll go with collectathons. Okay. So, that is why I took off the past 2 or 3 days, because I've been spending a lot of time learning DK 101%. It's been really fun. I plan on doing a couple runs of those on like Monday or Tuesday, or possibly both of them, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. And I'll also be learning Banjo-Tooie. So expect a ton of streams from the 13th to the 20th.
Hold on a second.
And of course, like I said, the shirt tomorrow, which is going to be Nasty Party. It's going to be based on the Nasty Party emote.
It's cute as hell.
It is. It's really.
That's right. You guys have seen it. Oh my god.
By the way, if you guys are not following Nas, by the way, make sure you do follow him and are around for the partner spotlight as well.
Dude, mod ban. He's spamming the chat.
Oh, don't worry, I got
mod spam.
I got it.
And then also, you know, fuzziness as well, because he just talked. Please follow him as well. Right, actually, we follow all of us on the team. And then 360 Chrism. I'm just going to spam the chat because we forgot to do this.
Alex being a good man. Yeah.
I thought we would do this later, but we can do it now with the announcement.
Yeah, I think it's a good time.
We have to do it as people are talking so that they know.
Otherwise, they're all at the same time.
Right, Ray, yeah.
Gosh.
Okay, now Ray's, go.
Hello, my name is raysfire. I don't really have any announcements. I've got an announcement that I finish school soon, which is good. I finish next Friday.
Oh, that's gonna be
which doesn't mean that I have like any. I don't really have any like huge plans for the stream, but what it does mean is that I'll be able to stream more often. So
you're on this channel.
Did you get a haircut?
I did. Yeah, thank you for linking my channel. If you're here, this that link will take you right back.
That will take you right back right
now. But
check it out.
So if you'd like to follow, you can do it. But if you are gonna follow, I want you to respect Alex's dedication to linking. So please click the link before you follow. Thank you.
But for YouTube, twitch.tv/raysfire. There you go.
All right. Do you want to guess?
Okay, Sam. Turn. Yeah, your turn.
Oh yeah, and I got a haircut. Woo! All right, go Sam.
What's up, guys? I'm Red Falcon Games, and I have no announcements. But I'm out of school, so that's good. I'm done with exams as of like a couple days ago. So I'm gonna be streaming all summer. I'm just gonna be doing a lot of Paper Mario speedruns. I've been doing a lot of those on the grind, and also some Melee CPU tournaments over the summer.
Those are so much fun.
That's Red Falcon Games, guys. Those.
The next one is going to be a 20. It's the 20th one, so it'll be 64 entrants, and it's going to be awesome. So
those are all, I'll see are you guys there. Really hype. If you have not seen a Melee tournament,
but they're rigged.
Yo, Sam. Sam is getting close to partnership.
So close to partnership.
I want you guys to also give some extra hype in his channel and show some love and support.
Really
to him
important. Really important. We want especially in the next few weeks. Or months, depending on how long it will take. Make sure to support Red Falcon Games as much as possible.
Please,
because
it's really important to us. Everyone here, open up Sam's stream, open up twitch.tv/redfalcongames.
And never close it again.
And just minimize it.
I do that every day.
Yeah, same.
Yeah, so thanks, not guys. Only to make sure you follow, but tell everyone else to follow as well.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the number one announcements.
Yes, so what do we got here, Alex? Nice.
Yo, that's a hype announcement. I'm good.
No,
let's go.
Unfortunately, I don't have any announcements this time around. All I just want to say is that I have no announcements, but I love you guys. Oh, Nas!
Yeah!
Oh, Nas! I love you.
Yeah.
Yo! Wait, let me give you a high five on camera. Wait. We're gonna do it on three.
Oh, I'm still. Wait. You're next to each other, guys. Make sure you
left,
hit it
left.
Wait, well, I have to go. Wait, this way.
Yes.
Who can I?
This is working.
This is working.
In case.
I wanna high five someone.
I can. You can high five me.
Let's go. Okay. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
Hey. Yeah, that'll work. I'm sure.
God, what's up with the fan fictions, yo?
Wait,
just tell us what you're gonna play in the next couple days, Alex. If you don't have
I'm doing a three. I'm doing my famous three heart challenges for Legend of Zelda games. I do a lot of three heart challenges where I have like a bunch of crazy like things that mess up the run. You guys as viewers can mess up the run as well. They're really stressing, but in a way fun. To watch, I got VR of course coming up. Hopefully,
so much fun.
Virtual reality.
VR. Oh my god! It's
you
so
gotta watch reality
those horror games, dude.
I'm trying to get another version of that horror game. I hated it, but I still want to do it because I was laughing my ass off when I saw my highlight.
Alex got spooked so hard that he fell over.
He fell.
I did fall in the game. It was right in front of me. I was like, whoa!
Check out Alex's highlight where he gets a sub and he pours this like drink all over this random robot.
Oh yeah. When I got someone subbed me, I started like pouring like ketchup all over like the of the robot.
It was so funny.
That's pretty good.
But yeah, like it's always hype in all of our streams though, guys. So if you guys are new here, please check all of us out because we're really tight team. We're really
like
close
streamer,
to each other. We're really similar in ways, and I don't want to tell them about the other things that we do.
So, Vesper.
I can't tell them about the other things. Oh, Vesper.
Okay, I've got no, announcements. What I'm kind of doing with my channel right now is I'm playing a lot of RPGs, playing JRPGs, playing Xenoblade Chronicles right now. It's a lot of fun. Gonna play some Disgaea. Gonna play, I don't know. I'm letting people vote for the games that I play. It'll be fun. If you like JRPGs. I hope you check it out.
Is Bonnie's Hide and Seek a JRPG?
Yes.
Okay. This is good. So we need.
Also coming up, events to meet us will be SGDQ is most of the people in here right now.
We'll have another podcast before that.
Oh, yeah, we will. Oh, okay. So then we'll.
There, just I don't think that. In the next upcoming month, is there any events you guys are going to? I don't think so.
I'm going to DreamHack Austin. I'll be there tomorrow through Sunday. So
see,
if
there you
Austin,
go.
if you see Raysfire, please kiss him for me. there's what big events? There's E3. What else big events are coming up?
I'm going to DreamHack in June.
ESA for some of us.
ESA.
ESA and DreamHack.
When is PAX West?
PAX West? Oh, yeah, PAX West as well.
When maybe Evo for me.
They changed it to West. I don't know. PAX Prime.
Did
West.
So
stupid. Yeah, they changed it to West.
Yeah.
That's like early September, I think.
Okay.
I'll be at E3, PAX West, TwitchCon, Zeldathon. If you guys know what Zeldathon is.
Oh, when is Zeldathon?
You're going to Zeldathon?
Yeah, I'm going to Zeldathon.
Oh, cool.
It's cool. Is it June 18? I think it's June 18. It's a huge marathon, and we just play Zelda the whole time. All the freaking... When I say all the Zelda games, it's all of them.
It's literally all of them.
All of them. Even the bad ones.
Even Link's crossbow training.
Is it the CGI?
Everything. Yeah, so I'll be there. I'll be like... I guess I'm just going to be like chilling on the couch and doing all the
I wonder
silly
what's
things.
For dinner.
Like that come on the...
Guadala!
You dare bring light into my lair? There, you must die.
Chrism, are there any like team specific stuff that you want us to like announce right now?
We have not decided on dates yet for next level summer, our team event.
I'm still loud, damn it.
Thank you guys for all the feedback, by the way.
Yeah, we got so much feedback on the spreadsheets.
We put out a feedback form on Twitter, on Next Level Live Twitter, or sorry, Next Level Twitch Twitter.
That's a good thing. We should shout our Twitter out.
Yeah, go and if you still have feedback for the marathon that you didn't get it in, we have a link for a feedback form on the Twitter. You can go find it there. We'll still look at the feedback. Like, it's not closed yet, but we did get a lot of feedback. It's helped us a lot. Like, we're making a lot of decisions directly based on the feedback, and so like we really thank you guys for that.
Totally
It means a lot.
All right,
but yeah, like that is a great idea, is to follow the
please follow the Twitter. Yeah, we post so many things about
we usually tweet. We don't tweet out every single one of our streams every day. We only tweet out the special stuff, so
you know, the special stuff.
We're not gonna spam you.
Yeah, you will always find something good to watch if you follow the Twitter.
It's not gonna be like clogging up your news feed or anything. And if you want, you can fill out some of the questions there about the event and give feedback as well if you haven't done so already.
Mm-hmm. All right.
That's it.
Okay, guys. Well, I think that's going to be it from us for now.
Real quick, guys. Okay, what I want you guys to do right now is I want you to tweet out to Next Level on Twitter with you a picture, take a picture of you taking sunglasses with the hashtag Next Level Live.
Or a beanie covering your entire face.
Yeah, whichever you want to do. I want to see that, guys. So, is there anything else that we're going to say right before? We're going to do the thing?
Over the headset.
Go ahead, Raze. Lead us. Lead us.
Hashtag Next Level Live is going to be the tag for you guys to post those pictures to us. Get nice and cool. And then we're also going to be using this hashtag as well for the raid that we're going to be going on.
Oh yeah,
so
we're raiding.
Guys, this is gonna be it for
explain
this is gonna be
it
for us for today. So if you guys don't know what raids are, if you're new to Twitch or whatever, or if you're listening on the podcast, a good way to show your support of another streamer is everyone in the chat who is watching this stream goes to another channel and we share the love with another broadcaster. So today's raid target is actually gonna be a good friend of a lot of ours. One second.
Definitely a friend of the team.
Yeah, friend of the team, a really cool guy. His name is Mr. Mike Feedback, and
I like Mike.
I haven't been able to check out his stream yet.
Mike's awesome.
You
nice.
Should. He See, rated this is the perfect me. Opportunity.
This is your chance.
Yeah, I know. This is actually good. This is good because he rated me. And
let's go, guys. Get hyped.
So,
we want to see in chat.
Guys, hold on. Chris looks like a mushroom.
I look like a Smurf.
It's Link.
So here's a link to his channel, guys. Go spam Next Level Live.
Go destroy his
chat. Love. Oh wait, I didn't. I typed it wrong. Someone give me a link because I don't know how to type. And then go give him some love. Anyways, thanks for watching, guys.
Good job.
Wait, who has a link?
Or from us
I do.
Today. Yeah.
Post it
there. Nas is the link.
Go.
Link. We're good. That's going to be it from us for tonight. Thanks so much for tuning in, and we will see you guys next month. Have a
good
one.
Thanks so much, guys.
See ya. Bye-bye.